Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Here you can see this is little Zera and he is a little foster cockatiel of mine. He has actually been adopted and he is waiting to go to his new home, but I thought it would be really nice if we could do a little video on him and tell you his story. So Zera is a cockatiel of unknown age. He's a male. And he came to us as his owners could no longer afford him, and he actually was, he came with two little budgies, and his owners were also moving to a smaller place where they couldn't have pets. So that is how he came to us. So Zera is actually a really, really sweet little boy. He is actually super quiet. Shame, he doesn't make much noise. He's just a really peaceful bird, and you know, having him around, I've been telling people that he's such a calm presence. You know, like in a busy world, it's so nice to have him just be a beacon of peace. Honestly, he's just such a sweet little boy, and so he is currently here with me in Port Elizabeth, but his new owners are in Johannesburg. So on the 6th of September, he is going to be on a little plane flight to Joburg. And when he gets to his new home, he's going to have two other little cockatiel family members. And I think he's going to get on really well with them. Zera is actually, he's not necessarily hand tame. He doesn't like hands much and being touched, and we think this is because his previous owners used to like force him to cuddle with them, and they would maybe hold him when he didn't want to be held, and so that's just given him sort of a real dislike of being touched, which is completely fine. Like I said, he's really just such a sweet presence. You know, you don't have to force a bird to be something they're not. If they're not a cuddly bird, then they don't have to be. He also came to us just eating sunflower seeds and millet, but he's done really well. He now eats the healthy Parrot Hotel seed mixes that we stock. And he does love pellets too. Still a little bit not 100% keen on veggies, but he's a good boy and he'll get there soon. I have been calling him Zera the whole time. He was named Corky the Cockatiel in his previous home, so we decided to give him just a new name to symbolize the start of his new journey. But his new family is actually going to be renaming him Zorro. He's also not a particular fan of toys, but I have given him some bottle brush leaves, some nasturtium leaves, and he enjoys like picking and playing and investigating with foliage. So as long as you know, you've given the birds the opportunity to interact and engage and explore something, then that's all right. It doesn't have to be the like stereotypical store-bought toy in order for you to be doing what's best for your bird. You know, as long as you're providing something that they enjoy, then you're doing a good job. Cockatiels in general make really, really great pets if you're willing to put in the time, you know, to make them toys or like spend time with them, bond with them, make sure that they're not just, you know, a piece of furniture in your home. They're living beings, and even for a bird like Zera who doesn't necessarily enjoy physical contact, you know, it's about still being there for them and just sitting with them, enjoying their company. And cockatiels are intelligent too. They can also learn to do target training and tricks, and for really
advanced parrot keepers who are very dedicated. Some cockatiels have been taught to free fly, and I wouldn't suggest that for someone without the help of any professional training, but it's just an interesting thing to add. You know, cockatiels aren't, I don't know, some starter pet that isn't intelligent, and they're really great creatures.
Thank you.